My name is Sarah Connor, and I am your Miss PSC, as you all know. And tonight, for PSC Tonight Show, which is, this is my second episode, we are talking about the dress code. We are here to help you today because I want everybody to be fabulous, because when you look good, you feel good, and you do good. So true. So, today we're going to have a few people modeling what to wear and what not to wear to different occasions, of course, because everything in your closet has a time and a place, but on campus is not the time and the place. Do you understand me? Yeah. Okay. And now we will begin our mini fashion show of what to wear and what not to wear. Complaining about the dress code, wearing on the street. If people don't start dressing appropriately, they will be fined for their lack of following the dress code. Now, how do you all feel about this? And do you think it is important for us to have a dress code here at Philander Smith College?
I personally don't think that we should have a dress code only because we are grown and people shouldn't have to tell you how to dress, and we are all individuals, so my style is not like the next person. But like she said, perception is everything, and when you're going to class, you shouldn't wear things revealing to where your professor is uncomfortable, to where he or she has to look at you a certain way because of what you have on. And that's what happens a lot of times when you're in the classroom and you have a certain attire on. It makes the learning experience uncomfortable. So to avoid all of that, you know, like, be mindful of what you put on or whatever, because you don't want to be offensive to anyone.
When you come here and they accepted you, you start to represent more than just yourself. So when someone's on campus, alum or something, and they might want to donate money, and then they see you walk around with your pants sagging because that makes you comfortable, you might have just lost money for the school. So, you know, we grown, it doesn't have to be too strict, but you need to know how to dress yourself, and just because you're grown doesn't mean you know how. That's
about it. I guess I can also say I'm as well as a fan of the dress code. Just simply because, okay, I guess a lot of times, I guess we come from places, you walk out the house and your mom or your dad doesn't stop you. So I guess you necessarily don't know what is good and what is, well, what is appropriate and what is not appropriate. So I guess having the dress code, enforcing the dress code, kind of gives you that, just so when you do go into the business world, you know not to go into an interview with jeans on, all right? You do not know not to walk around campus with a lace shirt on and a pink bra. Why people do that, I have no idea. And then also you attract, and then you ask why boys want to hit you on a, on you, but are coming at you sexual wise, like, that's common sense to me. So I am a fan of the dress code.
Now, to you all, do you think that it is okay to judge people based on solely how they look? Because sometimes people may appear one way, but actually they're another way. So do you think it's okay to judge people based on how they look? You may look like a hooker, but what if you're not a hooker?
I'll speak on that. Personally, I wouldn't like to judge people based on how they appear, but I know that in the real world, in most people, eyes, they will view you based on what they see. So, you know, especially people who have never met you before. I've experienced this first time. So, I will tell all the young ladies and the young men out there just to represent yourselves well, because you don't want to give people the wrong impression of you.
When you go to the dining hall, or when you go to the mall, or when you go to your grandparents' house, they don't want to see this, right? They don't want to see your pants sagging.
Appropriate dress, I would say, for instance, of what she has on right now, or the young man that was up here with the business suit, some of the other guys that had on casual wear, is very appropriate. Because me personally, I'm security at the Rust School District, and trust me, I get tired of seeing these little boys walking around here with their pants hanging. It's not appropriate.
If you look like a thug, they are automatically labeling you like that. School is going to be harder for you. If you look like a thug, because they're going to be like, it's just sort of like the guys that always get in trouble in our schools, kind of like going to sort of dress that, because they always assume that they were going to do it. You might not have been doing them sometimes. You know, and it's like, I've seen like situations where the people that are actually dressed nice were the people that's actually going wrong, but nobody would ever know that because they perceive this, oh, he's dressed nice, you know, his pants not sagging, he's a good guy. And so I think to some extent you should just keep up with it wearing, but I mean, you can't really know a person until you actually talk to them, but people are going to approach you how they feel about you when they look at you.
My standpoint on this one brings me back to business organization management. It's a class I've taken here at the campus, and I have Mr. Johnson. He told us a few times, he constantly tells us this, so we just understood. And he started off as our work ethic, and how even something as small as you turning in your work a certain way is a direct representation of yourself. So if you come out of your dorm room or something like that dressed any kind of way, that's a direct representation of yourself. You come out of a half dress, you say, I want y'all to see me half dressed. This is who I am. But if you come out of a shirt and tie, looking professional, that says, I'm a professional young lady, or I'm a professional young man, I'm wanting to go somewhere in life. So let's be mindful